Hello children, today we are going to learn about the chapter number 5, that is presentation visual effects. In this chapter we will learn the following topics. We will learn in this chapter the introduction to PowerPoint, how to apply animation effects, how to add transition effects, how to insert sound and video clips, how to use action buttons, how to import data from Word, and how to view the presentation and slide master. Previously, we have discussed from this chapter the following topics. We have discussed introduction to the PowerPoint, applying animation effects, and different categories of animation effects. Today in this video we will learn the following topics from page number 47. We will learn how to apply animation effects on following, on single object and multiple objects. We will also learn how to reorder the animation effects. Now open your computer book at page number 47. Here you can see in the first paragraph of page 47, to see the more animation effect, we have to click on Add Animation drop down menu. We can also click on More drop down arrow of animation group to select the multiple animation objects. We can add more than one animation effect to the same object, and we can also add the same animation object on multiple objects. Whenever we are adding any animation effect to the object, you will notice the numbered tag will appear next to the object on slide pane. Now let's see it using practicals. Click on Start button. From Start sub menu, click on Microsoft PowerPoint 2010. After clicking on Microsoft PowerPoint 2010, PowerPoint window will be open on your screen. Now you have to make the presentation with 3 or 4 slides. Here you can see I have made a presentation of save trees with 4 slides. Now I will apply the animation effect on these slides. How can I do that? Now, first of all, we have to select the slide on which we want to apply the animation effects. For example, I am going to select here number 3 slide. Here you can see images are also appeared and the text is also there. Here you can see if I want to apply the animation effect on this text, I have to click on this text. Now it is selected. Go to the animation tab. Under animation tab, below this animation tab, you can see the animation group where different animation effects are appeared. You can apply any animation effect to the text. I will click on this shape effect. You can see the more effects by clicking on this drop down arrow. From here you can see number of different animation effects. We can also add animation effects from advanced animation group by clicking on this add animation buttons drop down arrow. Here you can also see the different animation effects. Now here you can notice one thing. I have applied one animation effect on this text and here it has been appeared with the number 1 tag. It means I have applied first animation effect on this object. Now you can also see I can apply more than one effect on the same object. Click on this object to select it. From animation tab under advanced animation group, click on add animation buttons drop down arrow and select any other effect. For example, I'm going to select here underline. Now here you can notice I have applied two effects on this same object with numbered 1 and 2. We can also see these animation effects in animation pane. To add animation pane on your slide pane, we have to click on animation button. Under advanced animation group, click on animation pane button. Here you can see on the rightmost side of your slide pane, animation pane has been appeared. It is ordered with number 1 and number 2. We have applied two animation effect on title 1 object. Now let's see its preview using preview button. Click on animation tab. Under preview group, click on preview button. Here you have seen we have applied two effects on the text object and both animation effects have been displayed one after another. Now we will see how can we apply the same animation effect on multiple objects. Here you can see in this slide multiple objects are there. Here is one picture, this one is shape, and here one more picture. I will apply the same effect that I have applied on text object. Here you can see I have applied here underline and shape. Now I want to apply the same shape effect on different objects. First of all, select the object on which you want to apply the animation effect. Now click on animation tab. From the drop down menu of animation group, click on shape. Now select any other object. Again click on shape. Select one more object. Again click on shape effect under animation group. Here you have seen I have applied same animation effect on different objects. Now we will see in animation pane you can see the numbers indicates the animation order and star symbol indicates the type of effect that we have used on object and text. Let's see it practically now. Here you can see in the animation pane, numbers are given that shows the order of animation. And with the numbers, you can see the star symbols that shows the type of effect that we have applied on our objects. Now let's see its preview. Click on animation tab. Under preview group, click on preview button. Here you can see in which order we have applied the animation effects. All the effects are being shown in that sequence. Now look at your book at page number 47. Side question of the second Let's Know More. Here you can see we can also remove the animation effect from the animation pane list. How can we do that? First of all, select the animation effect that you have applied. Now click on the drop down arrow next to it and select the remove option. Let's do it practically now. Here you can see we have applied a number of animation effects, and in the animation pane you can see the list of animation effects. Suppose I want to remove the number 5th effect. Just click on the animation effect. There you can see the drop down arrow. Click on this drop down arrow. Here you can see at the last you will get the option remove. Now click on remove option. You can see the number 5th animation effect has been removed from your animation pane list. Now look at your book at page number 47. Here in the last second point you can see we can also reorder the animation using reorder animation button. How can we do that? Let's see it practically. Here you can see in the animation pane, 3 animation effects have been applied. We can change the order of these animation effects. Suppose I want this animation 3 to be displayed on the first number. Hold down this animation effect with your left mouse button and drag it to the position where you want to drag it. Here I have dragged the number 3 effect on the first position. Now we will see on our slide. Here it was previously with number 3. Now it has been replaced with number 1. Let's see its preview now. Click on preview button under preview group from animation tab. Click on this preview button. Here you can see firstly this image has been appeared and afterward the text has been appeared on your slide. Till now we have learned from page 47 how to apply animation effects on single object and on multiple objects. We have also learned how to reorder animation and how to remove animation effects from the animation pane. Now revise all the step questions till here and do practice of these questions.